Going to the book of Jeremiah.
Thank you, Lord.
Going to the book of Jeremiah. Jeremiah, Jeremiah.
Thank you, God.
Jeremiah, the 18th chapter. And verse 1 through 4. That's Jeremiah, the 18th chapter. Verse 1 through 4. And today I just want to talk about something that maybe go with you a little while. And somebody said, an extreme makeover.
Makeover.
Come on, say it again.
An extreme makeover.
Now, I don't want to cause a religious or a church fight, but may I appeal to my clergy brethren. I know that you badger the women and talk about them. They want to do certain things like beautify themselves.
All right.
But you must understand, man, sir, preacher, reverend, etc., etc., etc. The greatest quality a woman have is her beauty.
Amen.
Come on. And she go to the extreme to look good.
Praise him.
Come on, y'all. Help me out. Help me out. All
right.
Whether it's something she want to do with her hair.
Amen.
Something she want to do with her nails.
Amen.
Something she want to do with her lips.
All right.
Oh, come on.
Come on now.
Maybe something she want to put on her ears.
All right.
Whatever make her feel good.
Amen.
Come on. And I know that a lot of y'all have been through some changes. You've been whipped. You've been buked. Not really buked. You've been buked.
Yes.
And scorned.
Yes.
Come on. I know you have.
Yes,
but I'm finding out in 2017, we got more men in the beauty shop than we have.
Wow. Really?
Watch out now.
Whew. I'll be a minute. I mean, we, come on, coming up, we bash the women, we beat them up. You can't wear this, you can't do this, you can't do that. You better not do this right here. You're trying to look like this right here. Oh, God. But now in 2017, you can't get a chair because they had a chair with their feet in the wall. Y'all don't want to talk to me. Oh, God. I ain't trying to start a fight all the time, but reality. This is not fake news, so you ain't to worry about Trump, he's all right. Come on. They are pedicured, manicured down. Come on. Come on, they're skin toning. Y'all don't want to talk to them. They're hair grooming. Come on. But all they can do, they want to look beautiful. So, sir, reverend, doctor, apostle, prophet, teacher, evangelist, whatever, one of the greatest qualities I want to have is, first of all, is inward beauty.
Amen.
Then secondly, when she look in the mirror, she starts to change what she see.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all ain't saying
that. Come on, Pastor.
She start off early that morning with hair going on this side. Before it's over, it's back on the other side.
Yes.
Y'all don't talk to me.
Amen.
Come on. Before she get out the door, it may be thrown to the back.
Amen.
Mm. By the time she get where she going, maybe in the bunion.
Woo!
Amen.
Come on. Come on. She's a jack of all trades.
All right.
Come on. And you'd be surprised when she get home. She just don't get home and do like we do, men. We just kick our shoes off, just sit down and say, oh, man, she had a hard day. Woo! You'd be surprised how she going to be able to breathe again. I'm going to leave all that alone. Y'all don't understand. Men, y'all don't understand none of that. She just wants to say, just want to breathe. Come on, somebody say, she just want to breathe. Come on, somebody say, she just want to
breathe.
We sit at the dinner table and then just relax and say, sure was a good meal. No, that don't work for her. I ain't going to bother that. But extreme makeover is something I want to talk about in the spiritual realm, not more so in the physical realm. Let me throw some skin for you free before I jump into this word. See, the enemy, he saw something happen on the day of Pentecost. Bible said they was all gathered in one place. Waiting on a move of God.
Yeah, they were.
Come on. In the process of waiting on the move of God, the Bible said, and the women was there too. If it was good enough for the mother of Jesus to be there, how much good can it be having your mama in church? So on the day of Pentecost, Brother Christian, the Bible said when the Holy Ghost came, it brought the fire. It was the fire.
Yes, Lord.
Come on. Then after the appearance of fire, the Bible said they began to speak in tongues, and the Spirit gave them what to say, gave them utterance. And then the book said these words, and Jesus said to them, go ye, and you shall be endowed with power. Somebody say, with power. Say it again, with power.
Power.
Now we can see this power being demonstrated not just in the elements of the tongue, but we see this power being demonstrated one day Peter just walking down the streets, and right in the alleyway there were sick folks laying there, and while he walked by, his shadow just leaned over and covered the folk. Not the hand of Peter, not the arms of Peter, not the prayers of Peter, just a walk by shadow. Someone say, walk by healing. Now you heard a drive by shooting, why not a walk by healing? You just walk by and the people got healed. I got good news for you. There's power. Someone say, power, 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 power. If you receive the Holy Ghost, you shall receive power. Someone say, power, 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 power. Somebody say, power.
Power.
They receive power. Deacon Bradley, the enemy, saw that. He said, I got to do something about this because I can't have these tongue-talking folks walking in power. I don't mind you talking in tongue, but I can't have you walking in power. Did you hear me? I said, he said so many words. I don't mind you talking in tongue, but I can't have you walking in power. And we got a whole lot of church folk just satisfied with sticking by my side and tie my bow tie. He come in a 100-mile conversation. I was a hell of a talking church. I don't know what he coming in, but one thing I do know, he shall bring on the clouds. He's going to reappear.
God know what's up.
Hello.
So the enemy had to throw something in the works. He got into this thing called religion. Got into this thing called church.
Come on.
Because he didn't want the church to recognize and realize it. It's not about your tongue. Thank God for your Spanish. Thank God for your German. Thank God for your, I wish I had a talking German. Thank God for your fluent Russian. Thank God for your ability to speak nine dialects. The enemy, thank God, he realized that, listen, I don't care nothing about your talk. I'm concerned about your walk. I don't care nothing about what language you speak in. I can talk different languages too. But one thing I do know is, I don't want you to wake up and realize that you got power. I want you to understand that you got power. You got power to bind me. You got power to cut me, to stop doing what I'm doing. You got power to hold me down. You got power to arrest me. You got power to lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. You got power to call those pain which be not as though they were. To my bunker, they say, power, power. Say, you got the power. You got the power. Say it again. You got the power.
Hallelujah.
So he throws something in there, Brother James. He got into the church.
Preach it now.
He got them start looking at one another. And they start hyping on things.
Come on.
They start hyping on stuff about your hair. Your clothes. Your nails. Your lips. Your fingertips. I'm sure I had a talking church. How long your hair is. How short your hair is. I'm sure I had a talking church. He started addressing things that could be physically seen with the natural eye and put you in a carnal battle. Which means he calls you to start sword fighting one another and get the fight off of him. I wish I had a talking to him. He got you sword fighting one another because of the color you live in, the color you have. Hey, y'all ain't saying that. Hey, y'all ain't saying that. What church you go to and what name you're baptized in. He got you all pulled down with those carnal teams so he can get by and still do his dirty work and get by and still cause sickness and get by and still cause disease. So we got this battle.
Preach it.
We got time and things. If I say things.
Things.
Huh? Where there's unity,
there's unity.
So there's one Reformation. Start looking at the other Reformation. Start saying, y'all ain't got it.
Come on,
my God.
Because you don't baptize us away.
Come on, man.
How many demons you heard being cast out because somebody got baptized? Baptism come in the area of through repentance, which means I confess I'm a sinner. I confess I was wrong. I confess I did wrong. I confess I walk contrary. So baptism come in not to wash away my sin, not to wash away my flesh, but to sanctify me in the eyes of the people. Let the people know I'm going down confessing my sin. I once was lost, now I'm found. I once was bound, now I'm free. So then, we got tied up in the battle. We start solidifying one another. Start picking things out. You got on this. You got on that. You do this right here. You do. So that got the battle off of him. And that went on from generation to generation to generation. And that caused him to set forth his imps to operate in the earth. And it caused the church to lose focus.
Yes.
While we were looking at one another, we couldn't see him.
Come on.
Child, did you see what I saw today? That choir member had red fingernail polish on. I couldn't see the man that was sitting in the back who had crippling arthritis in the hand. Which was more important, the red fingernail polish or the man with crippling arthritis? Ooh, wish I had a daughter. Which one's more important? Come on. To be able to lay hands on and say, be healed in Jesus' name. And that cripple on the rise. Lord, leave that body. That's a testimony to somebody else. If he done it for him, he can do it for me. If he healed my daddy, he can heal your daddy. If he's...
Come on now.
Yeah. That will win souls.
Yes, Lord.
That will testify of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, thank you, Jesus.
That will speak of the kingdom.
Yes.
You think the Lord concerned about if your lips are blue, black, orange, gray?
No.
He won't know. Are you confessing me with your lips?
Amen. Amen.
What does it mean if I'd have had clean lips and still cuss? Wish I had a talk to him. What would it mean if I had clean lips and still tell lies?
Come on, Pastor. Come on.
Come on.
Well, he's concerned about what comes out of my mouth, through my lip, more so what goes on my lip. Were they glossy? Were they clean? Or got Vaseline on them?
Come on, Pastor.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
But they indoctrinated us with that to blind us.
Come on, Pastor.
To keep us from recognizing the work of the enemy. It's about the saving of the soul. I'm trying to get to this string maker in a few seconds. And I'm going to show it to you. It's about the saving of the soul. It's about my son, my daughter, my husband, my wife, my friend, my whoever that's bound in sin. I want to see it set free by the power of God. So I say by the power of God.
By the power of God.
Let's see this in stream maker. What it says, Jeremiah 18.
Yes, Lord.
In verse 1, what it says?
The word of the Lord.
The word of the Lord.
Which came to Jeremiah.
Now this mind blowing. Now the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah.
Say.
What did it say?
Arise.
Get up. Somebody say, first thing you do is get up.
Get up.
Say, when God's word comes.
When God's word comes.
Get up.
Get up.
Now I'm not talking about standing when you hear the preacher about to preach or somebody read the scripture. I ain't talking about that. But when you got the word, maybe you're on a taste. I'm getting up. I may be down, but I'm getting up. I may be feeling bad, but I'm getting up. I may have lost some things, but I'm getting up. Why come the word of the Lord? The word of the Lord come to get me up. Somebody say, get up.
Get up.
What is saying? Arise.
Arise and go down to the potter's house.
Now, this is the part that I say is a shocking and amazing. 18 verse of Jeremiah verse 1. 18 chapter something, verse 1. He said, go down to the potter's house.
And there I will cause thee to hear
and
my
there,
word.
Now, watch this word. We're close. Brother Junior, watch this word now. I will cause you to do what?
Hear my word.
I'll cause you to do what?
Hear.
Hear. I'll cause you to do what again?
Hear.
I'll cause you to hear what?
My word.
My word. I'm going to cause word.
And behold,
here come.
He wrought a work on the wheels.
I heard a work being wrought. He did what?
Wrought a work.
He wrote. He, in other words, he was working on the wheel.
Yes.
God sent him down there to hear. He ended up doing what? Sin.
Right.
He went down and saw the power working on the wheel. He went down and seen the power working on the wheel. Sometimes, baby, it's not what you hear through your natural ears that give you clarity and understanding, but it's what you see God is doing. It's how you see God is moving, and it will speak to your heart. That's how you hear God. Sometimes you hear God by what you see.
Yes.
Come on, Pastor.
He went to the potter's house and he saw him working on the wheel. Read it.
And the vessel that he made of clay.
Nothing pertains to his hearing. The vessel he made of clay, he saw it.
Was marred in the hand of the potter.
The vessel was not figured just right. It wasn't molded right.
It was marred. In the hand of the potter.
It was in the hand of the potter. Read.
So he made it again.
So he done it again. Somebody say, I'll do over. Say, Lord, do it again. Jesus. He done it again. Read it.
Another vessel.
Another vessel.
As seemed good to the potter to make it.
It seemed good to the potter to make it. Here it comes.
Then the word of the Lord came saying.
Now here come the word saying.
All house of Israel.
All house of Israel. See, sometimes you can't hear nothing until you see God move. You can't hear a thing until you see God move. I gotta see the move of God. I gotta see God working. I gotta see God changing it. I gotta see God fixing it. When I see the hand of God, now I can hear instruction. I can hear I am the head and not the tail. I am blessed and not cursed. I am healed and not sick. Somebody shout hallelujah. Israel.
Cannot I do?
Cannot I do?
With you as this potter.
As this potter began to make this vessel, and this vessel was marred in his hand, and he relied, I'm going to do it again. Oh, that's what I'm going to talk about right now. Go ahead and finish reading it. Lord,
say
Jesus.
The Lord, behold,
yes.
As the clay is in the potter's hand.
As the clay is in the potter's hand.
So are ye in my
so
hand.
So are you in my hand.
O house of Israel.
O house of Israel. You can close the book. You ought to realize that you are in the hands of God. I don't care how things are going. You are in the hand of God. And you ought to say, I'm here today for an extreme makeover. Lord, anything in my heart that's not like you, make me over again. Anything in my mind that's not like you, God, make me over again. Anything in my walk that's not like you, God, make me over again. In my conversation, make me over again. In the covenant that I keep, make me over again. I don't want to be lost. I don't want to lose out. I don't want to lose fellowship. I want to be in you, God, and let you be in me. So make me over again. I can stand a makeover. I say I can stand a makeover. I need your help. I need your strength. I need your guidance. But help me to hear God. In order for me to hear, I might have to see. I gotta see the hand of God as it begin to move. Somebody shout yeah. When I see God moving, then I know without a shadow of a doubt that I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me. I can hold on. I can endure. I can make it. Shout glory. I need a stream makeover. I want a stream makeover. It's not over yet. It's not over yet. I heard the songwriter say, please be patient with me. God's not through with me. Blessed Stream Makeover.
Yes, God.
A little dab of do.
Oh, yes.
It's better than Brea Cream. Yes, it is.
Hallelujah.
A little dab of do. Come on.
Hallelujah.
The songwriter said, please be patient with me. God is not through with me yet. Oh, please be patient with me. Y'all know that? God is not through with me yet. Remember what? When God gets through with me. Remember that part? When God gets through with me, what you gonna do? I shall come. I shall come forth as pure gold. Say, I don't need that costume stuff, man. Come on. I don't need, somebody say, I don't need no gold plated stuff. I need some real gold stuff. Some stuff that's been through the fire. See, you see, right now, when it comes to your walk with God, you don't need no cosmetic stuff.
Come on, Pastor.
Come on. Some of y'all is old enough to remember you couldn't afford gold, so you got silver.
All right.
Come on. You couldn't afford to go to the dentist like some of the other people on the other side of the railroad track to get the real open-faced crown. So you created your own. You got the double mint, the silver, the paper,
yes.
The spearmint paper wrap.
Right.
Put it on your tooth. Suck it on.
Yes.
Some Reynolds wrap.
Come on.
Suck it on.
Yes.
Some of y'all ain't old enough to remember that, do you? So you created your own silver tooth. Couldn't get gold. You created your own silver tooth and you act like it was a real silver tooth. Every time you talk, you talk like that. You talk to my folks so if you can see it. Y'all remember that?
Come on.
Well, we don't need no cosmetic stuff.
No,
I need to know without a shadow of a doubt that he's real.
Yes.
Lord.
You need to know without a shadow of a doubt that I receive an extreme makeover. And in this makeover, he's doing it again.
Oh, yes, he is.
Don't let the enemy talk you out your power. Talk you out your strength. Everyone is standing.